Well, there is, as I said, great potential in this fast bowling unit. We have a couple of bowlers who can clock 145 plus on a consistent basis. And also the fact that we have Ishant, who's pretty experienced. He can extract that extra bounce off the wicket. And of late, Ishant has been extremely consistent. And that's a very, very encouraging fact. And Bhuvi's had a wonderful tour in Zimbabwe, where he's rediscovered himself. He's moving the ball pretty well both ways. And so we do have the variety in somebody who can move the ball and seam the ball, and someone who can extract that extra bounce, and a couple of bowlers who can clock 145 plus. That gives us enough variety for us to battle any conditions. Something which sacrificing pace, I wouldn't definitely would not want. But yes, it's a wrong concept sometimes that people who bowl fast are generally erratic. But as you get more and more efficient in your action and your thought process, I think you can be fast and accurate, like many of the other bowlers in the world over have proved. And the challenge for these two would be to remain, not compromise on their speed, but the challenge would be to get a lot more accurate. Well, I think Bhuvi, there was no problems as such, but again, he had the ball that he could bring it back in. He was having trouble with that. So I guess it was just a question of the release point, and he worked pretty hard on that, and I guess that made a huge difference. The fact that he could bring the ball back in like what he used to earlier, that made him a lot more potent. Well, I guess it's very difficult to speculate on what we would be expecting, and unless we get to those conditions and take a look at those conditions, we are not sure. If you look at the series against Pakistan, they were pretty spinner friendly wickets, but unless we get to the venues and get to assess the wickets, we wouldn't be knowing the conditions too much. But all I can say is that we are pretty well equipped to deal with any conditions that we may face.